Hello, Southland, and of course, everyone else who's been staying connected with us through our video updates. This is the week we're expecting to learn when and how our state will begin opening back up. And we've been informed that the governor of Indiana will make a presentation on Friday, May the 1st, about which organizations and businesses can resume operations. We've also been told he'll outline what protocols will be required in reopening. Now, what I can tell you today is that Southland will definitely have online services only this Sunday, May the 3rd. We want to be prepared in advance and feel we should focus our efforts to another week of online since we don't know how the new protocols will impact us. Now, once we hear the state's directive, we'll put together a plan and inform you immediately about our next steps. Keep in mind, if we're still permitted to start public gatherings, we'll consider what is required of us before making a decision to open our doors for in-person worship. In the meantime, we'll continue doing everything we can to keep you connected, served, and encouraged. So do me a big favor. No matter what you hear other churches are doing, please pray for and support our leadership as we make decisions for Southland that we believe are best for our congregation. It will do the most good if you trust our judgment and stand with our team. We're just as anxious and excited as you are to get back together with everyone in person, but we want to evaluate the data and consider the safety of our people first before making any firm decisions about when and how we'll gather. Look, I totally respect other church leaders and their decisions for their people. Southland is an intergenerational church that is uniquely impacted by COVID-19. We're taking into consideration every demographic in our thought process about re-entry strategy. So our approach may look different than your friends' churches. So stay positive and stay with us. And as I said before, stay tuned and I'll do my best to keep you up to the minute with our plans. Okay, now one point of encouragement. I want to remind you of our Bible Project reading program we've initiated this year. If you haven't started yet, this would be a great time to do so. Go to thebibleproject.com and register, or go to the App Store and search Bible Project and download the app. You'll receive a tremendous reading plan that will give you a big picture view of Scripture. In addition, there are awesome videos that explain the context of the Scripture you're reading, and you'll experience God's Word like never before. I can't tell you how much I've enjoyed this program myself. I've learned so many things that I can apply to my life every single day. And one of those things I've learned is so relevant for our current situation. This past week, I was reading Psalm 106. The psalmist both praises God for his blessing, while at the same time is searching his own heart for any need to repent of spiritual failure. He even refers to a plague God brought upon his people to get their attention, showing them they were not in a right place with him. I bowed my head and asked God to show me any attitude or place in my spirit where I needed to repent. It was a great time of confession and turning toward his grace and his word. And that's what the Bible Project's been doing for me. And I hope you'll choose to dive into Scripture like never before in these days. It might just open your eyes to something you need to adjust in your life. Okay, stay hopeful, stay faithful, and be encouraged. The Lord isn't finished with us yet, and Southland has so much to accomplish in serving and blessing our community and our world. And just a reminder, this Sunday, May the 3rd, in both services, Danny Beasley will be our guest speaker. He's going to challenge us to live out the gospel by staying focused on our local and global mission. It'll be a great way for you to see how your mission, faith, promise, giving is impacting the world. I know I can't wait to hear his message. So keep praying for us as we do all we can to be the church for the glory of Jesus Christ. Stephanie and I love you, we miss you, we're praying for you, and we look forward to that day when we can be in your presence and hopefully hug your neck. Probably not right away, but eventually. Now go make today a great day.